It really is a special pleasure and privilege to welcome the Minister here. And
I would like to thank the Minister, the DG, the DDG, as well as the Department for really, you know, giving us support at NSFAS to be able to do our work, execute our mandate. But also, you know, I'd like to also thank the staff at NSFAS who've been working under tremendously pressurized environment, who have really come to the party, as well as, you know, some of the people, including some of the private sector, that have assisted in making sure that at the end of the day, we can fund more students and we can meet our mandate.
No, it's very useful and helpful, you know, to understand progress that is being made, but also to understand some of the obstacles and capacity problems that are facing NSFAS, especially at this time of the year. But I am impressed by the hard work that is being put in by the Executive Committee of the Board and staff in terms of the work that they are doing. Some of it is not easy, it's very complicated, and we are dealing with an uneven situation. For instance, some universities were writing exams only now. The results are not yet out, and you need to factor that into the process. But I'm encouraged on the whole about the work that is being done, and even the problems that are there have been identified, we then will be able to deal with those. Well, I really want to say to the NSFAS staff, they are doing great work. What they are doing, actually, I told the worker representatives that I met that they must always remember that they've got two bosses. The one boss is NSFAS management, the other boss, which sometimes is very difficult to satisfy, are the students that they are actually helping. Because the work they are doing, it's changing the lives of our young people, you know, who get opportunity and hopefully they graduate and then their circumstances change completely. So we say to them, NSFAS staff, keep up the good work. We know that they are not working under the most ideal conditions, given some of the challenges as I've outlined in terms of capacity and so on, but they continue to do the work. I think that as a country, we need to appreciate that.